Okay, took me two drafts to make it this far, but I am in the finals. Six lands into Hiri's Wrath. I'm not fundamentally opposed to keeping six lands and an insane mythic rare, but this is one that particularly does not go well. I mean, it goes okay with six lands, but the thing is, I'm probably going to need to draw like two creatures to have some kind of board presence. And then draw another spell before I can use the Nahiri's Wrath. Also, a lot of my spells are cheap. It's not like I have a ton of 5 and 6 plus mana spells where I can just discard one spell and a bunch of lands to wipe their board. Think I'm gonna grudgingly mulligan this hand. And I'm going to grudgingly keep this. I almost never mulligan to 5 with the new Scry rule. Okay, so if I draw a mountain, I can still be in good shape. If I draw a swamp, I'll be okay. If I don't draw any lands, then maybe not. Sure. Right. If you told me I couldn't draw a mountain or a swamp, then that's probably the next best thing. Yuck. I don't really want to trade off with Exultant Cultist. So I could attack with both, or I could do nothing. What's the advantage of doing nothing? Are these creatures ever going to do anything better than trading? I guess I should just attack. It's also good to attack if my opponent's intending to emerge next turn. Wow, missed land drop even with the Exultant Cultist dying. Well, now I just have to pass because I don't want to let the Geist transform. Sure. I wish I kept six lands in Nahiri's Wrath. There we go. So my best play, I think, is Olivia. My opponent still did not hit a land. It's pretty absurd. My opponent's turn is like crack the clue, go, then I can definitely race. I'm not completely dead, even though I am behind. Wow. Almost unbelievable. My opponent 16 cards deep and only 3 lands. And I hit my fourth land, so options. Cast the Mentor. If I do, I can give it haste or not give it haste. I don't think it makes much sense to cast the Duelist. I could cast Olivia's Dragoon, give it haste with Senseless Rage and Madness that. Can I get in the most damage if I give the Stromkirk Mentor haste? I guess that's what I'm gonna do. So this comes into play. The Mentor pumps up Olivia, and the Olivia pumps up the Mentor using probably this Gurzdag Supplicant. Or maybe the Otherworldly Outburst. Yeah, I guess the outburst. So what does my opponent have to do to get back into this? Probably has to involve killing Olivia. Blocking is not going to be a good plan because I have the Duelist in my hand. Keeping things tapped, bouncing things, killing things. Those might work. Blocking won't work. Okay, that's a good start. And I would guess that my opponent's intending to crack the clue this turn. So what I could do is cast Collective Brutality. I could use up to all three modes. Not sure if I love that play though. Maybe the best bet is just duelist and attack with both. Sure. Well, that was definitely a good turn for my opponent, relatively speaking. But still, he or she has a lot of work to do to come back from this. I thought my draw was bad, but my opponent was stuck on three lands for a long time, and I think it was probably one turn too late that he or she hit the fourth land. So this turn, I will make the play of Collective Brutality with three modes. Target opponent, target creature, target opponent. Two mana, discard a swamp and a Skurzdag Supplicant. And yep, take away pour over the pages. Opponents at three and attack for lethal. Okay, no changes. I don't think I sideboarded at all this whole draft. I got pretty much just crossed the finish line in terms of playables. I wouldn't have been very excited to play Cemetery Recruitment, Magmatic Chasm, or Thirsting Axe. I could have seen boarding in Magmatic Chasm against like a green deck or something, but most of my opponents have been more trading and removal based than blocking based. Let's see if both players can get a better hand this game. I definitely have a better hand this game. And I haven't gotten my my joy of actually getting Indulgent Aristocrat to survive yet in this deck. Maybe this will be the game for it. Alright, coming in for one. Well, now I can play Stromkirk Condemned, and I can comfortably attack with the Reaver. I don't really want to trade my Aristocrat for the Uninvited Geist. If my opponent's missing red mana, this is going to be a massacre. Next turn, I can play the Stromkirk Mentor, attack, and threaten to have three three power creatures attacking, that is, with more in reserve. Sure. So I guess I could discard in response to make the Geist not able to attack. I don't really care about that, though. You can have your 3/3 creature. Or I could otherworldly outburst my Indulgent Aristocrat. Actually, that seems like a fine option. I really want the Aristocrat to be good this game, but I don't want to play badly just because I'm attached to my pet card. Well, I think I'd rather just play two dudes rather than the Mentor. So come in for five. Play the Condemned and play the Reaver. A little bit of a shame to just beat up on a mana screwed opponent two games in a row in the finals. My opponent's deck looks like it's very good if he had more functional, he or she had more functional draws. But it is worth noting that that's the advantage of playing an aggressive deck in draft, is if your opponent just has a bad draw, you give them very, very, very little time to draw out of it. Alright, so I'm going to play the Mentor, give Stromkirk Condemned a +1/+1 counter, attack with everything, no matter what my opponent blocks, I'm going to discard a card to the Condemned. Keep the Skurzdag Supplicant in hand because I am putting my opponent to two here. So it's conceivable that, say, my opponent wipes my board with Nahiri's Wrath, then I could play the Supplicant and still have a lethal threat. I guess I just attack. Can't even think of anything my opponent could have. Yeah, that's not gonna be enough. All right, so Red Black Vampires gets the job done. Thanks a lot for watching. Tune in next time.